Sarab Jeet again, and welcome to your own channel, Small and Strong. Here we talk about the small things that may seem small, but they make us strong inside and out. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe. And if you are returning, then thank you so much for your love that you have been giving us. As you all know by the title that today we are going to talk about mental health. But what makes our today's video special is I'm gonna give you some tips and tricks that are surely gonna help you in your journey. So to begin with, I must tell you that it is not that long ago, 2 to 3 years ago, when I was encountering some major life issues. And you know what? It totally affected every relationship that I ever had. Long story short, I was totally mentally imbalanced. Gradually, I realized that nothing is working out in my life. I was not having any vision that what my life is gonna be in coming years, what I'm gonna be, what I'm gonna do. I didn't had any idea about that. So one day, I realized that I'm the only person that is going to save me. So I promised myself that I'm not gonna give up. First step is you need to focus on your thoughts. Guys, you may have never noticed this thing, but the first thought in the morning when we wake up or when we just have opened our eyes and the first thought that comes in our mind is a negative thought. It could be anything from, damn, I'm getting late for my office or for my work, or, oh my god, I'm surely gonna miss my class today. And this one negative thought in the morning starts a series of negative thoughts that bump into us one after the another, and we don't have control over it. So what we can do about it? We can change it. It is as simple as that. Think about the last thought that you had corresponding night. Guilty, it must be a negative thought. So from today onwards, make a habit to listening to good music and think about the good things that you like. Like for me, it is my nephew. I see his pictures on my phone and I listen to the sound of the rain, and it makes me so calm and quiet that I sleep like a baby. And when I wake up in the next morning, guys, it's a bliss. I still have negative thoughts in the morning, but the frequency is reduced from this to this. See? And that brings us to our next tip, and it is keeping a gratitude journal. What you guys understand by gratitude? It is simply being thankful for the things you have in your life. Guys, here we need to understand that gratitude is not an emotion. It is not in our DNA. It is an attitude that can be opted out. Gratitude simply shifts our focus from the things that we don't have in our life to the things we do have in our life. Guys, every day when I go to my office, I need to walk for 10 minutes after leaving the metro. And for that 10 minutes, when I walk on this hot summer under the hot sun, guys, it is very uncomfortable. I'm sweating and I'm everything, and I could barely catch my breath. And once I reach my office and there is a beautiful centralized air conditioning, and I feel like this. So at that moment, I realized that I am so blessed that I can work in air-conditioned atmosphere. All you need to do is grab a journal like this or download any mobile app on your phone and jot down the things that made you happy throughout the day, from a compliment that you received from your coworker to a new job that you got on that day. And that will make you so happy and so thankful towards your blessing, and you will start feeling positive from that moment onwards. And when you start keeping a gratitude journal, gradually you will realize that your mental health level is rising up, and you are having lesser and fewer negative thoughts in your life. Guys, next big thing that can help you with a good mental health is your inner voice or your intuition. Our inner voice, our inner self, always knows that if that person is harmful for us or if we are gonna enjoy the party that we are going to. But what we do is we push aside that thought and go ahead with that, the mathematical calculation that our outer self projects in front of us. Start making decisions that feel easy to you. So listen to your inner voice. That is the best friend you have since birth. The next tip I have for you is being in the moment and focusing on what is happening right now. So many of us are either living in the past or in the future. Either we are always worried about the things that are gonna come in our life or the mistakes that we have made, the regrets we have. So we are always rushing around and we forget to enjoy the present moment. We are sitting with a beautiful person and having a beautiful, lovely candlelit dinner, and we are thinking about the thing we had at our work or the servicing our car needs or the taxes we need to pay. Guys, stop doing that and for once, try to enjoy the moment you are having and try to be in the moment and try to be with that person totally. Guys, life is beautiful when we start focusing, when we start paying attention to what is happening right now. You will get to know that there are so many things that are so beautiful and we just, you know, miss the chance to look at them. So every now and then, take a break, give yourself a moment and just look around and notice what is happening. Your heart will surely catch something attractive and you will feel happy about it. So guys, these were the tips that I had for you, and you can be positive and maintain a good mental health level by using them. If you like them and use them, please comment in this section below. So guys, thank you so much for the love that you are giving to this channel, and if you haven't subscribed yet, please click on the circle that is showing my face, and I will be sharing the link of my other videos too. You can click on the screen and be happy, be positive, enjoy your life, and I will be coming back soon with interesting videos. Till then, keep loving yourself.